Okay, students, I welcome you all again for your economics class. Today we will continue the same chapter, that is money and credit, and we will discuss the topic that what is meant by formal and informal sources of credit in India. In last one lecture, we have discussed last point, that is what is meant by terms of credit. I hope now you will be knowing now what is meant by credit, is it? What are the terms of credit? Why credit is taken? Is it? But now question is here, now people have requirement of loans, there is need of loans, but what are the sources here from we will get this credit? This question will come in our mind. Today we will discuss this point, that the sources where from we will get the credit are two, formal and informal. Is it? First I will give you the concept regarding what is meant by formal source. Formal source of credit is that kind of source when we are getting loan from formal sources, there is applicability of rules and regulations, means rules and regulations are followed, like as we are taking loans from banks and cooperatives. When loans are taken from banks or cooperatives, that is the case that we are taking loan from formal source. Is it? Second one is that is informal source. Informal source is that kind of source when we are taking loans from the source where no rules and regulations are followed, is it? Or no terms of credit are there. If terms of credit are there, but they are totally non-favorable for the borrowers, that means that is known as for informal source. Like as we are taking loans from money lenders, big landlords, businessmen, relatives, or from friends. These are the examples of informal source. Now, what is the comparison between these two? That means formal source of credit is that kind of source where we are getting loans, rules and regulations are followed. In informal source, no rules and regulations are followed. Is it? Secondly, informal source, someone is supervising it. Like as in India, RBI is supervising all the monetary situations, or all the commercial banks are monitored by RBI. But in informal source, no one is supervised there. No private organization or not any government organization. Is it? And in formal source, credit is favorable for the borrower because rate of interest is low. Is it? Repayment of loan, that is easy. Instead of that, in informal source, rate of interest is very high, and that is varying from people to people, borrower to borrower. Is it? And secondly, that is not favorable for the borrower. And repayment of loan in informal source is not good for the borrower. Then another question arises here, why formal source is best? Is it? Formal source is the best because loan will be provided to each and everyone, there is no discrimination, rate of interest will be low, is it? Rules and regulations are followed, is it? There will be no discrimination with anyone. That is why the formal source is the best as compared to informal source. Another, why informal source is discouraged? Because rate of interest is high in informal source. Secondly, it is not favorable for the borrower. Repayment of loan is not suitable. Is it? Means no provisions are there for repayment of loans. How much will be asked to return? The borrower has to return. And lastly, it is not good for the poor people. No doubt in Indian economy, if we will go back, you are seeing this point that majority of the Indian people are taking loans from the informal source because they are not knowing, it is not suitable for them. And in our mind this question comes when they will take loan from the formal source or from any bank. Is it? They have thought regarding this issue, we have to fulfill the terms of credit. We have to fulfill their documentation. We have to provide collaterals. But they are not knowing this is good as compared to that they are taking loan from informal source. rate of interest is doubled there. Is it? No doubt they have no requirement of documentation or collateral. But that kind of loan which they are taking from the informal source, that is not good for the borrower. And next point is there, supervision of formal source. I have touched this point here. In India, informal source of credit, taking loan from banks or from cooperatives, it is monitored by RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India. Reserve Bank of India is checking all the monetary activities of all the commercial banks. Is it rate of interest, payment of loan, repayment of loans, whatsoever, that means all the transactions or the activities done by commercial banks is monitored by some agency, one agency, that is known as RBI in India. Another one, no supervision role in informal source. In informal source, there is no one who is monitoring this. The rate of interest is suitable, repayment of loans is up to mark or not, means no one is there who is checking all these activities in informal source. Now last point is there, what is meant by cheap credit, and it is necessary for rural areas. Yes, obviously cheap credit is necessary for rural areas. What is meant by cheap credit? Cheap credit is that kind of credit when loan will be provided, is it, at low rate of interest, is it, and terms of credit will be very easy. They should not be very harsh, like as if borrower will not fulfill all the terms of credit. That means cheap credit is that kind of credit in which rate of interest is low. Secondly, terms of credit are very easy. Like as I will touch one point, Government of India have initiated one program, that is KCC. KCC means Kisan Credit Card. In Kisan Credit Card, rate of interest is near about 7 point something, below 8%. Otherwise, rate market rate of interest is 12.5 or 13%. That is the scenario. Why government have provided the loans to farmers in KCC at the rate of 7 or 8%? Only because the concept is cheap credit. Because the motive of the government is that all the farmers or all the persons who have requirement of loan, they will be able to get loan at low rate of interest, and terms of credit are very easy, is it? And there is no requirement of collaterals, mortgage देने की कोई जरूरत नहीं होती है इन चीजों में, है ना? This is the case that is known as cheap credit, and this cheap credit is really a best component for the rural areas, because you are knowing in rural areas most majority of the people are not aware regarding their monetary transaction, are not aware regarding their loans which commercial banks are providing, is it? And they have thought once again that rate of interest is high, we have to provide documentation, we have to provide this collateral, is it? For that question, the government have to take steps that majority of the rural people mainly will be encouraged for taking loans from the farmer source, and at the cheap credit, is it? At the cheap credit, is it? It is a concept which government will introduce. Cheap credit, is it? This is the scenario regarding what is meant by formal and informal source, comparison between these two, and why formal source is best, and why the informal source will be discouraged. Okay, thank you.